So today we're going to try and convince even the most frugal of landlords or building owners that you can save enormous amounts of energy by swapping out fluorescent tubes for LED retrofit tubes. Now, we haven't looked at these on the channel ever before. So as ever, when it comes to lighting, we turn to some trusted experts, and we've got hold of some CorePro LED tubes by Signify. But first off, you got a little bit of a mission, didn't you?
Yeah, you sent me down to the toolbox. I swung open the door, and it wasn't just the lights above my head that looked like they were from yesteryear. The shop itself looked like maybe where Arkwright would have been behind the counter. It had bric-a-brac from everywhere.
Yeah, but it's a very useful shop in town for if you need those any hardware bits. But yeah, it is a little bit like going to open all hours.
Yeah, it is.
And we'll get on to those operating hours a little bit later on. But you've brought back what I best describe as a relic of a light fitting. So it may be an old shop, but it's certainly they've skipped a few generations of energy saving potential. So we've got here a fluorescent baton fitting with conventional magnetic control gear in there.
Yeah.
Switch starts. Yeah, so this looks, yeah, so we're going to use this as a little case study to show how much money and energy we can save. I mean, interesting that even the lamp itself was an original Philips, wasn't it?
It was, yeah, and they're 58 watts and they are 1500 mil, aren't they? So in length, 5 foot, I think you find in your day, back in the day. However, so when I'm thinking about changing out, I'm thinking about saving energy. I'm also thinking about the amount of time it's going to be paybacked in, okay? Mm. So that payback time to me is really important. And I know when they were thinking about supermarkets and changing over to LED back then, they were talking years and years and years. So I'm going to take a bit of convincing how much energy I'm going to save and how long it's going to take me to recoup my investment.
Okay, but the good thing about energy retrofits with just replacing a lamp is you don't have to obviously touch the fixed wiring.
Right,
that's where some costs can come in. But think of those applications, the shop there, clearly they've managed to miss out, yeah, the potential to save energy, so they weren't interested in changing to LED fittings, but there may be some other reasons why you can't do that. There might be some asbestos in the ceiling, the wiring might not be up to quite the latest standard, and you don't want to have to go through any rewiring, or the fitting itself might be, all the value might be in the fitting, so we sometimes see that in, say, like an underpass,
where you
have vandal-resistant fittings and things like that, where a quick fluorescent, you know, change out, put a lamp tube in, is great. Great. So we're ready to go on this. We've got our Haymeg power meter here, Gary.
Okay, so let me bring this in. I'm going to have a little look at what you're up to.
Yep, so we've got our tube connected through the quick test. We've got our power meter, so there's a line voltage, the current draw, and the wattage.
Okay.
So I'm just going to connect that up and boot up our fluorescent thing. You ready for this?
Yeah, we should hear a dunk, dunk, dunk.
Yep, it's magnetic. So there we go.
Okay, and
we're on.
We're on, we're struck, yeah, so we're off and running.
Yeah, so the first thing you might notice is when I look at the power, it's a 58 watt tube.
Oh, wow. Well, it can't be a 58 watt tube because we've got 66 watts there.
Yeah, and obviously one of the reasons we went to electronic ballasts, we went from magnetic ballast to electronic ballast in the past was because we gained energy efficiency by doing that. And obviously you can see there's quite a bit of power is actually lost in magnetic ballasts.
Okay, so when I'm thinking of the high frequency style ones, if I put a 58 watt tube in, I'm pretty much at 58 watts.
Yeah.
But these style ones, we've got a little bit more wattage in obviously the gearage.
Yeah, and obviously the tubes warm up. Remember, we used to say the lamps warm up as obviously fluorescent tubes get to their peak operating temperature. You can see actually the power's actually increasing there. So we're nudging up towards 70 watts. So we'll use 70 watts for our calculation before we look at the LED retro tube. So cost wise, so we'll say.
So you're going to now try and prove it to me. Okay, so we've got about 70 watts.
Yeah.
Okay, and I reckon that shop, by looking at the doors open 6 days a week and approximately 10 hours with the opening and obviously the finishing off.
Cashing up in the evening.
And looking at that shop, I wouldn't think it'd take too long to cash up either.
Okay.
So you're going to do one tube for me over that period of time?
Yep, so I reckon, okay, we've got 10 hours a day.
10 hours a day, 6 days a week.
Six days a week.
I can do the maths on you here. Okay. Don't need Joe Robinson for this one. I think that's 60.
60 hours.
It is.
And let's go 52 weeks a year.
Okay. Oh, makes sense, doesn't it? I suppose there's only a few days they're going to be shut.
That is 3,120 hours.
Yep.
Oh, our fluorescent tube's flickering away there again.
Okay, I'll just take it out of the way, so we're not having that. So
now, gets back to energy price. So let's just, before we go to the number. I remember, obviously, I've been lighting quite a while, not quite as long as Gary and his old metric imperial measurement conversion there. Energy price, we used to do this at 10 pence a kilowatt hour. That was an average price going back, you know.
The people watching this would love a 10p, so what are we going to go for, about 25?
25p, I think that's where we're at the moment. Okay. Obviously, in the current climate, energy prices are all over the place, but you know, that don't look like we're going back to low cost energy for a while. So I think 25 pence a kilowatt hour.
However, by the time we finish this video, we might be near a 28p. So the sooner you get on with the calculation, the sooner we can have that energy price locked in.
Yeah, so we're going to convert our 70 watts into kilowatts, so 0.07 kilowatts.
And you're going to multiply that
by 3,120 hours.
Okay, and then we're going to come up with that 25p, is it?
0.25 pounds. So.
Okay, so this should come out with the number to run just the one, isn't it? Just the one light fitting. You're going to come up with a number for me, and it's going to be for those 6 days at 10 hours. Let's wait. Drum roll, please.
£54.60 a year.
For one.
For one.
I've made the maths nice and easy for you, because when I was down in the shop, we actually replaced 10 of these, well, in your day, 5 foot, in my day, 1,500 mil long tubes at 58 watts. So you can multiply that number by 10.
Yeah. £546.
So let's say, yeah, so about 550, yeah? Yeah. We'll go, so nice and easy, £550 for 1 year to run the lights in that shop.
Yeah.
Wow. You know, take a deep breath. That's a lot of money, isn't it?
It's a lot of widgets to sell, and screwdrivers, paint, sandpaper, things like that. So that's that tube. So now we're going to change it. And this is quite an easy process for the LED.
Okay, so like an easy process. Okay, so just pop out this one. Yep, so this one's going to come out of here. Let's have a little look inside it while you're fiddling around.
So you can see the magnetic ballast.
Yeah, you can. No capacitor. That shows how old it was.
Yeah.
Okay, and it even had red and black flex connected to it, which was that. So we're going to take out the starter.
Yep, so I'm just going to take out the starter itself.
And you're going to replace that starter. And the replacing starter inside of it, I've taken one apart already, has just a link. So in other words, we're going to link this out. A starter effectively is just a switch, isn't it? It just open and close contacts. So you've put the new one in. So that's in there, which effectively just shorts out the starter position.
Yeah, so you would have to put a sticker on there if you're doing it. Obviously, you don't want to, in the rare circumstance, someone would want to go back to fluorescent technology. So right. Reverse retrofit.
So they wanted to go back to using lots of energy.
Yeah.
And they managed to find some of these tubes.
Yeah.
And they put them in, obviously. Yeah, that's going to need to be replaced at the start. We don't want that shorted out. Yeah.
Okay. So there is a warning label should you do that. Now, the tubes themselves, got two versions here.
There's lots of information on the end. Can I have a little look at the end?
Okay, well, as it is Philips, there's a reassuring amount of information and some all-important safety certification.
Okay.
So there's two versions. There's this version here will work with magnetic control gear or director mains.
And that's the one with the blue cap?
That's the blue cap. And we've got the universal one here that has a little bit more electronics in it and slightly higher output, higher performance that will work with universal. It gives away work both magnetic and high frequency ballast without having to change anything.
Yeah, and that's the one I went for when I was down in that thing. I saw the word universal. I thought, I'm all right here. So I didn't have to think about anything. I just installed those. You said the other one's called EM. When I see EM on anything in lighting, I think emergency.
Yeah, no, so it's in the Philips world, that's electromagnetic ballast. So that's the big lump of iron we've got there.
Okay.
So these tubes don't work with emergency conversion. So you may find instances where a fluorescent fitting has been converted to emergency use, so there's another set of control gear. They tend to generate incredibly high voltages that aren't suitable for these. So.
And you also said I could use this one, the EM version, direct to mains.
Yes.
So that would be whereas maybe I've got a disconnect altogether, I've got to do a little bit of internal rewiring.
Yeah.
Am I thinking there maybe where I've got the high frequency style ones, that gear over time possibly starts to wane a little bit, when we want to get rid of that and just bang straight to the lamp.
So an old installation
with
electronic, but it's getting towards its end of a life from the control gear. You can drop that out and wire the mains direct to the end cap.
Yep.
And you'll actually see on the end cap here
it is
labelled
with
a mains input if you wanted to do that.
Oh yeah, okay, that makes sense. But of course, I played it safe and went for the universal.
We went for the universal.
I did. Okay, so you can pop this one in for me, so you can use the version.
Now, again, you'll notice on the back, this has a 270-degree light output. You can see actually down the back of the tube where the LEDs themselves are.
Ah, so that wants to face the fitting.
That wants to go, back into the fitting.
I would like to suggest for the record, the first one I put in, I put it the wrong way round.
Okay, so you were back. Did you actually put it the wrong way around?
Well, no, Rick did.
Yeah,
but I instructed him he'd done it wrong. I was trying to save Rick there, actually, when we went down and changed. So that's all in.
Yep, so I'm just going to power that up.
We're going to have any dunking now, so just instantly on.
Instant light output.
Yeah, that's good. I like that.
And they say no warm-up period.
No, there is no warm-up.
You can see the power level.
Wow, is that 23 watts?
Yeah, so we'll go with 23.7 for our calculation.
Okay, so we should be a bit quicker on the calculations now. 23.7, okay, so you've got all the other numbers. Already in my own mind, I'm thinking this is going to be a big saving. 23 watts. What were we, about 70 Casio on the other one?
Yes.
You wouldn't want to make a calculator today, would you? So here we go. What's our numbers?
Yeah, but you could probably buy them in that shop still. Right, £18.48. So we'll round it up, £18.50.
Okay, so what were we before? Just remind me what we were before.
£54.60.
Wow, just take a deep breath there, I would suggest. So we've changed out the tube, and in that period of a year, wow, what we saved ourselves overall for the 10 fittings. I'm sure you can multiply that by 10.
184.
Do your calculator.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's huge. It's fantastic. I would suggest this is...
£362 a year saving in that shop just by... Popping out 10 tubes. How long did it take you?
If we said 2 hours, I probably did chat. I gave the bloke behind the counter a little bit of flannel because he allowed us to go in there and change those tubes. There was a little bit, a little bit of relationship building before we started.
Yeah.
However, I think if he'd have watched the video of us changing the tubes before letting us go in and realised what he's going to save, it would have been an absolute yes, please, and when can you start, wouldn't it?
Yeah, and that is, that's an absolute, I think that's one of the fastest energy paybacks I've ever seen, and possibly an area you may not think of it. Everyone just assumes fluorescent tubes, reasonably efficient. We probably did our halogen lamps years ago.
Yeah.
What a simple process.
Yeah, a totally simple process. So if we just go through that process when me and Rick was there, of course, Rick got out the steps, and Rick went up the steps, and then obviously we replaced those lamps that were in there. We isolated the supply. This can't be done live, so we're not twisting these out and taking out our tubes when the electrical energy is obviously in place. And then it's a case of dropping out your starters. So in this case, we had twin fittings. So we had two starters.
Oh, the twin 58 watt. That is the workhorse. You'll find them in water treatment plants, car parks, everywhere.
You will.
Yeah, but as I say, they managed to skip back. The shop owner hasn't bothered for years.
Absolutely. And then we put in, obviously, the ones that link out that starter. Remember, you're going to need to put a sticker on if ever the process gets reversed. And in go the new tubes. And I would suggest the only thing that was a little bit nerve-wracking for me when we were there, and this is my time in electrical maintenance, was the fact that the ends of tubes tend to dry out, don't they? Those plastic ends tend to dry out. So, of course, when you're twisting them, there's always a little bit of a nervous moment.
Now, Gary's been on about it. Ever since he got back, he used to, back in the day when he actually used to do real work, he claims there was a special spray he used to put on the end caps to help with that process.
Yeah, and I think it was one that also improved the conductivity of the terminal, so it was also like a cleaning agent. But you wouldn't believe the difference between a little squirt on the end and twisting round, because one of the ones we did, it did lose a little bit of the material that was using to connect the end cap together when we twist it, and you could just see the little bits breaking away. We obviously really was dry.
And that is probably, if you can remember what that spray is, drop it in to help Gary's memory with that. But that's probably one of the biggest challenges of this process. You know, the retrofit itself is easy.
Yeah.
And again, that reason to switch the mains off, you possibly don't know the condition of the fittings that you're working with, and that's why they're there. The tubes themselves, as I said earlier, safety certification, the sort of quality and build quality you'd expect from Signify. Not necessarily all tubes you'll see on the market have that level of safety. So again, we go with trusted brands. Yeah. Great performance. We've got the 5 foot version, or the 1500 millimeters if you're living in the metric world. There's lots of different flavors. Yeah. There is a slight difference in output between the EM version and the universal. But again, there always was differences when you went back to T8 tubes. There's lots of different flavours in terms of the phosphor in there. In that project, obviously, you walk into a shop, there's a whole raft of different colour temperatures being installed over the years. But we opted for the 4,000 Kelvin that we feel is right for that sort of retail environment. But you could go to 3,000 Kelvin or 6,500 degrees Kelvin as well. But you know, if you're not doing this type of retrofit right now, this is a great energy-saving payback.
I think we painted a compelling story there for saving energy by simply removing the tubes and inserting the CorePro LED tubes from Philips. However, if you harbour a love affair for the ones that are going off to recycling, I've got some sad news for you. Come September 2023, they'll no longer be manufactured. I think this video deserves a follow-up video, because we also said that our fluorescent fittings could have the gear removed and the tubes go direct to main. So in our next video, we'll go into that and show you how that can be easily achieved, as well as looking into the fact, can we or can't we use these tubes in emergency fittings? As always, we want your feedback. Do you think this is a great idea to save energy? Because we certainly do. And you're thinking now of projects where you can simply insert these CorePro tubes in order to save energy for the customer. Please leave all those comments below, and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.